On Monday, the cabinet chaired by President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni resolved that the airport, which is currently known as Kabale Airport and also known as Hoima Airport, will be renamed Kabalega International Airport.
He is our hero, and indeed His Excellency is applauded for this because some people had proposed his name. He, as a good leader, a visionary leader, he decided to give this honor to our Omukama King Kabalega because he was a great king.
Grace Mary Mugasa, the State Minister for Public Service, noted that the decision came as a blessing. She adds that Kabalega was an inventor and a genius leader who united Bunyoro and inspired Africa to fight for independence.
Much as he was exiled, but he really fought for independence of Bunyoro against colonialism exploitation. Then he also spearheaded trade. They were doing barter trade, moving from here by foot slowly up to Egypt.
Mugasa has refuted claims that indicated that ministers from Bunyoro region had remained silent during the cabinet sitting, as majority of the ministers wanted to name this airport Yoweri Kaguta Museveni International Airport.
I was the third person to talk about this, and I reminded them how this proposal came about. It came about many years ago, and it was an advocacy from Bunyoro people, including the kingdom. So renaming it has not started today.
Meanwhile, other leaders and residents in Bunyoro region have welcomed the move and thanked President Yoweri Museveni for choosing to rename the airport after their late king who fought colonialism.
The government has already accepted that let these two industrial areas, and then of course when we are talking about oil and gas, but most importantly, the international airport that is named after Kabalega and also the industrial park. So for us, this is great, and I think even the people of Bunyoro can also use this one to remember.
Bunyoro, and I want to thank the cabinet and particularly His Excellency the President for really coming out and supporting that this airport of ours should be named Kabalega International Airport.
Residents say the move will help keep the history of their great king Kabalega, who did wonders for the region and the country at large.
It will keep and maintain us to continue remembering what Kabalega did for this region. And it will gain our, the coming generation will also take time to know who Kabalega was.
I'm looking at it as one way of boosting our tourism because we are going to own it now. This is going to be part of us. We are going to own it. We're going to call it ours.
And we will still put the Bunyoro Kingdom on map, even by the whites, the Western countries, the Bazungu who fought Kabalega by then, they will know that this man is still being recognized by the entire Africa and Uganda at large.
Omukama Kabalega ruled the Bunyoro Kingdom for nearly 3 decades, from 1870 to 1899. He died in 1923 after his return from exile. Today, the kingdom also marked 100 years since his death. Report compiled by Ambrose Niwagaba Katoto for the news.